I took the lead.
Somebody's heart muscle.
Good morning and welcome to the Morning Cupcake Show. Today we will be talking about age. Until when are we young?
I had a big accident skiing 4 years ago and I dislocated both shoulders same time. And since then I dislocated like a few times every year. So I knew that I needed to do this surgery. It was mandatory.
Sí que porta 5 sutures en aquest 3 davant I una doble darrere. Ja està, ja va així. Temps d'immobilització. Per la dreta el que hem fet hem dit 3 setmanes, que ja vam quedar. Sí. I per l'esquerra potser una més, que necessitem més temps de cicatrització per la lesió que tenia.
Jo penso que s'ha mentalitzat o ha interioritzat, no? I ara però hem d'insistir perquè tots el coneixem I crec que hem d'insistir sobretot en tots aquests plaços que hem dit.
I can see that the doctors and people around were a bit afraid because like, I really love to do activities and not to go to the gym or do these kind of things. The challenge in every recovery is that you need to build well the tissues and the muscles and everything to get back performing well. And in the other way, you don't want to lose fitness a lot, so you need to train and you need to start doing things. So it's a balance between going fast to recover, but doing well and taking the time. So that's the big, big challenge.
So now it's 4 weeks from the operation and I could take off my slings and start to do some exercises. So here I am, I can do this with 1 kilo and I can do this. Pop, pop. That's all. So here is the room where I will spend my next month to try to get my shoulders better. My torture room. I'm an outdoor person, I don't like to be stuck inside the walls, no? And I knew that I needed to stay like 1 or 2 months inside training indoors and just like living in. And that was kind of hard, but I was really mentally prepared for that. I think when you start a recovery from a surgery, you cannot expect I will be racing this day. My main focus is to recover. It was fun also that during this time, because I wasn't training a lot, I wasn't sleeping a lot, I was maybe sleeping every second or third night, so I had a lot of time. So many nights I was just like taking the computer and trying to do some like calculus in Excel to see like in like for example projects like timings that can be possible or like studying like taking some kind of training things and doing calculus. So I spend like many nights doing these kind of things. During this recovery time, it's also the time to take a bit of perspective and to take a bit of distance from what we do every day. So it's the time to go a bit forward and to see, okay, what I want to do for the next years and start to plan, and that's really fun, I love that. During all this time, my dreams had the shape of the mountains. What was super cool, it was during 2 months, I was just home and like being home every day and like exploring the mountains there. It's some big lines in Norway that I wanted to ski, like the troll wall. So I was actually driving many times like to the feet of the face and like looked at the conditions there. And that was so nice, like to not have the pressure or like the thing of I need to travel, but just like enjoying home and training a lot.
Stay tuned. Today we talk about turning 30. And the big question is, what do you look for in life?
So, 25 December, and going to ski for the first time after the surgery.
24.
Sorry, take it again.
No, no, it's good.
So,
Christmas,
yeah, 24
Christmas
of December. Yeah, around Christmas, whatever, like. It's not, that doesn't matter at all. The good thing is that we're going to ski.
So far, no bad. A bit clumsy. Not this bad.
Take care, huh?
That's the kind of thing they can do. We start training 40 hours skiing.
There is Emily. She wants to be so jealous skiing in the powder.
But yeah, it would be stupid of me to do that.
Maybe just a little. Woohoo! Woo! Oh, looks so cool, that.
When I am back to competition, it means that I'm not afraid anymore, that I can ski, I can go down, and that both physically, but also like mentally, I am ready back. It's I won't say, okay, my body is not as before, it's better.
About the famous content runner Kilian Jornet. He has been injured while he was leading with his colleague Jacob Herman the last stage of Pyramenta.
Oh shit, come on, is this a joke?
Now he has a fracture in the fibula that will set him aside at least for the following 3 months of the competition. This is our breaking news about Kilian Jornet's accident.